Hey everybody, Octane here. Just wanted to make a quick little video for basically the games that I played and uploaded for 2011. It's basically like an end of the year video. I'm just going to talk about the games I uploaded and, you know, my thoughts on them and stuff like that. That's pretty much all I have to say about that, so let's just get started. The first game I want to talk about here is Sonic the Hedgehog 4 Episode 1. Now, this is one I started late 2010, and I didn't finish till like mid-2011. It's not even a long game. It's actually a very short game. I just kind of got distracted. Well, actually, I got distracted by the next game I'm going to talk about, but Sonic the Hedgehog 4 Episode 1. I played the Wii version. You know, not a bad game. It's about average, I would say. It's not a terrible game, but it's not that great either. But, you know, I had fun with it. I didn't hate it as much as a lot of people did. Some cool levels. Some of them had some interesting gimmicks. The gameplay could have used some work, but as of this recording, Sonic the Hedgehog 4 Episode 2 was announced, and it's going to address a lot of the problems with Episode 1. Like they said, they're going to do a new physics engine graphical overhaul. So yeah, I'll definitely be getting that when that comes out next year. And I don't know if I'm going to upload it, but maybe. Oh, they did announce that it's not coming to the Wii. It's not planned to come to the Wii, so I'll have to get it on the PS3 or 360. But yeah, that's all I have to say about the game. Not, like I said, it's average. Not terrible, but not great either. But the next one is the game that I was distracted by that pretty much caused me to not upload Sonic 4 for quite some time. That was Donkey Kong Country Returns. This is another one that I started in late 2010. I actually started it like around the time it came out. And I didn't finish it until like early 2011, or earlier this year. Really amazing game. I had a ton of fun with it. I mean, I've played all three of the previous Donkey Kong Countries, and I liked them all. I loved them all, really. And then I played this one, and I was like, wow, this is, like, it's really good. It's great. Lots of difficulty is definitely the most difficult one of the Donkey Kong Country series. Yeah, I'd even say it's harder than 2. 2 had a lot of really difficult levels. Actually, so did 3. Well, 1 wasn't too bad, but it was, even though it was difficult, it was still, like, really fun and addictive. It's like, you keep dying, like, 50 times in a row, and it's like, jeez, I just really want to beat this level. Great music, great graphics, gameplay was nice. I didn't really have that many complaints about the game. It did have a lot of replay value, in the sense that, like, after you beat the game, you unlock some stuff, you get the extra level, and then you unlock the other modes, which I actually didn't really care about, but if you're one of the people that just want to completely beat the game, then you have other modes there. I just didn't bother with those. I still haven't. I don't know if I will. But, I mean, for what it's worth, the game was great. I did play two-player, like, not a recording, but like, on my own time. It was really interesting. It's actually really difficult playing with another person, especially if there's somebody that doesn't really play these kind of games. But Donkey Kong Country Returns, definitely one of my favorite Wii titles so far. Yeah, I definitely recommend it. And the next game is, I have a little list here, Monster Hunter Freedom Unite. This was just, I just basically uploaded a bunch of quests that my friends and I did on the PSP through Ad Hoc Party on the PlayStation 3. That was the first PSP game I owned. Like, when I got the PSP, that was the game that came with it. You know, Paul actually gave me, my friend Paul gave me the PSP. He bought me the PSP and that game and memory stick, which was really cool. I mean, it was a Christmas present last year, which is really nice of him. So we played that. I played Tri was the first Monster Hunter game I played. So playing that game and then playing this one was really different, because this one, the gameplay was a little bit different. Like, they fixed a lot of things in Tri that was, like, kind of iffy in this game. But this game features a ton of content. Like, there's way more content in this game than Tri. Actually, there's more content in this game than even Portable Third, which I'll talk about later. So, yeah, that was kind of just blown away by how much there was to do in this game and the different monsters and stuff like that. They just ended up removing a lot of that content for Tri. Not that Tri was bad, Tri was really amazing, but this one was, like, there's just so much to do. There's weapons that were in this game that weren't in Tri, and monsters that were completely different in this game or whatever. Different environments, stuff like that. Yeah, I had a lot of fun with it. It's a really fun multiplayer game. Definitely one of the best multiplayer games on the PSP, if not the best, along with probably like Portable Third. But yeah, great game. There are some things I don't like about it, like some weird hitboxes for the monsters and stuff like that. But it's oh, God damn it, I got a text message. Shit. I just totally interrupted my train of thought there. That's fantastic. Okay, I'm just gonna move on with the next game. Next game is Majin and the Forsaken Kingdom for the PlayStation 3. This was basically the first game that first playthrough I started this year, and it's cold, kind of random. I just remember the game was announced. I actually didn't start playing it until like I didn't buy the game until like months after it was released. I just happened to see it, and I'm like, well, this game actually looks really interesting. And I didn't really hear too much about it, but I found it for a pretty good deal online. Like, it was like $25, $30 used. 25, $30 used, and it's for, like I said, it's for the PlayStation 3. I played the PlayStation 3 version. It's also on the 360, but it's a really good game. Really underrated, and pretty much nobody played this game. Like, it got pretty good reviews, but the sales are not really good. And then earlier this year, like it was a game after this one, the developers of the game, Game Republic, they actually went out of business, which kind of sucks. But the game is good, very interesting gameplay. You have the protagonist who he's kind of weak compared to the Majin. He's like your muscle, and you basically your character you played as was like he did like the really basic combat and the puzzle solving, and then he had to work together. He had to split up. Really interesting dynamic. And it was a really interesting game. I liked it a lot. Very underrated. I would definitely recommend this game if you want something a little bit different, like a it's like a platformer with some puzzle elements, stuff like that. If you're into that stuff, definitely a cool game in the genre. Okay, next one. Next one is Pokemon Blue version. I actually never finished this one. I know a lot of people like kind of know why, but for those that don't, I had a ton of recordings, like hours and hours worth of recordings, that got deleted somehow. I really don't know what happened. So I kind of just gave up on it. I just moved on to the next game, which I'll talk about in a moment. But playing this game again, it was the first time in like years and years since I played this one. But brought back a lot of memories. The original Pokemon games were they're really nostalgic for me because I played them when they first came out. So I was really obsessed with them and yeah, I mean, the gameplay is it's a little dated, but it's still most certainly playable and something you still get really get into even now. Excuse me, jeez, I'm burping like crazy. I drank a lot of soda before this recording, though not a good idea. But yeah, I will finish this 2012, early 2012. It's like pretty much my main priority, like first priority for next year is to finish this game. So look out for that. I will start uploading it. I'll probably put a notice when I'll start uploading it again. Start recording and uploading it again. Anyway, next one is Cameo Elements of Power. This is the first game, actually the first game I bought for the Xbox 360. It was like $2, $2 used. Not it was like Cameo was it was a launch title for the Xbox 360. I remember seeing it too when it first came out. I was like, oh, this game looks interesting, but I don't plan on getting a 360. But I was given a 360, like the spring of this year or earlier this year. So I ended up getting that game. I was like, you know what? I'll get that. It's $2, and it's a fun game. Pretty short, but I wasn't really expecting a really lengthy game to begin with, but it's a cool platformer. The transformations to the different characters was really cool, and using that each one of them to fight certain enemies or go through parts of the game, that was fun. The music was I was really surprising. It was like very cinematic in quality, so that really surprised me. I didn't really hear any music from the game before that, and that was a blind playthrough, but The game wasn't too difficult. There were some parts where he died, but there's really not a huge consequence for dying other than seeing that stupid game over screen. But yeah, that was a blind playthrough and actually went pretty well. There were some parts where I was wandering around a little bit, but it was a fun game overall. Like I said, short, but $2, you can't really go wrong with that. All right, next game I'm going to talk about is Monster Hunter Portable 3rd, the Japanese version with the English patch. I didn't really intend on playing that one, but once Capcom didn't really say anything about this coming into the US, like officially, decide to get it, start playing it. Actually didn't intend on uploading it at all, but end up doing some stream recordings and end up being kind of popular, so end up doing some actual recordings of the game. And it's a pretty nice combination of what I liked about Freedom Unite and what I liked about Try, and they combined it and they added a bunch of new elements, new monsters, like armor sets, skills, a new environment, stuff like that. So, like I said, took the two games, the two previous games, what I liked about that, and combined it into one game. So, yep, liked it a lot. It's another game that I played with friends and stuff like that. Had a lot of fun, really funny moments and stuff like that I've uploaded. Not much I could say about it. It's Monster Hunter, more Monster Hunter, and that's all there is to it. Addicting as ever. Okay, next couple games I'm just gonna combine into one. That would be the Mario Kart game, Super Mario Kart, Mario Kart 64, Mario Kart Super Circuit, and Mario Kart Double Dash, which actually came out a little bit later, but I'm just gonna talk about all of them at once. Really refreshing to play all the games again, especially after playing the next game I'm gonna talk about. But going through each game and seeing how it started out and what they changed, what they added, what they removed, and stuff like that. It was really cool, and I got to play each game again. Like, it just brought me back because I pretty much played every game in the series. I own every game in the series, so I got them all when like they first came out and stuff like that too. So it was pretty like nostalgic going back and playing like Super Mario Kart and then Mario Kart 64 and all that fun stuff. Which actually starting those games led me to start playing Mario Kart Wii again, and that's the next thing I'm going to talk about. I don't think I should talk about it much because like I upload it all the time. Basically, I thought of like in my live streams. I do a lot of live streams, as a lot of you may know, and I thought of a game that I could probably play with my friends and also with a lot of like my like the viewers on the stream, like, and also a lot of my friends that attend the streams, like online friends, stuff like that. So, I mean, that one supports 12 players, so that was definitely a game that I picked out and don't regret like planning on playing that and stuff like that. Not much to say about it other than that, online is fun. I mean, there's some moments that frustrate you and stuff like that, but it led to a lot of funny moments, epic moments. And it's interesting because that was supposed to be like a little side uploads, but now Mario Kart Wii's like the uploads have become my most popular like series, I guess. So they get more views than any of my other videos now. So that's pretty interesting how that turned out. But yeah, I have, as of this recording, like the one I'm doing now, I still have hours and hours and hours and hours of footage to upload. So, I mean, uploads will probably eventually slow down now that there's a new iteration of the game come out. But the only thing is, there's no way for me to record that one. So, I'll probably record Mario Kart Wii a little bit less starting next year. But like I said, I have tons of hours of footage left to upload. So, it's not like you're gonna notice the slowdown in uploads until like a couple months from now, probably. I'm trying to upload them at a pretty decent pace. I've been doing like two videos a day. Some days I do three. But yeah, I still got plenty left to upload, so you don't have to worry about that. Some cool races coming up too. You're not gonna see them for a little bit, but there's some pretty cool ones coming up. Anyway, enough about Mario Kart Wii. Oh my god. Anyway, text message. That's my text message tone with the... Was that from Super Mario World? It's like... I think that's from Super Mario World. Anyway, I don't really care. Kirby's Epic Yarn is the next game I'm going to talk about. And this one was one I got last year, and I didn't play it till like almost a year later. Like, fully play it. Because I played through the game before, but like, I didn't collect all the treasures and stuff like that. And so, when I played it again, I actually looked for all the treasures, like 100%. And, you know, it's a fun game. Each level had something interesting about it, or a gimmick or something like that. The graphics were really interesting. The style of the game was really cool. I like that. And the transformations you had remind me of Yoshi's Island. Because in that game you got some transformations too, but in this game there was like a little bit more of a variety of them, and you saw them a little bit more often. But yeah, really cool game. A bit on the easy side, but I didn't really care. It was just plain fun to play, so I didn't really care about lack of challenge for the most part. I will say this, like, at the end of the playthrough I did know that there was some like parts of the game, like after you beat the game there's like some mini game stuff like that. I do intend on uploading those at some point next year. I just don't really have a set date when I'm gonna do that. Just, I guess when I feel like it. That's all I could say. And the last game I'm gonna talk about is Shadow of the Colossus HD, which is the last playthrough I did, and it's gonna be the last upload for new upload for this year. One of my favorite games of all time. I was like really looking forward to uploading it again. I mean, I did upload it before, but this one was better quality, but looked better, sounded better. I had new equipment, like compared to my old playthrough, and of course this one was the HD version on the PlayStation 3, so it looked a lot better. And you know, it was fun to play through it again. Not much more I can say about that. Again, kind of like Kirby's Epic Yarn, there is some extras after you beat the game. I'm not going to upload all of them. There is one in particular I do want to upload, but that's, again, another project for another day. But you'll see that sometime in 2012. I will note somehow when I plan on uploading, recording and uploading that. But yep, that is it for 2011. Had a lot of fun playing all these games, each one of them. Like, and none of them were games that I ended up recording and uploading that I ended up hating. I actually liked recording all of them. And, you know, hopefully you enjoyed most of them, or at least one or two of them. I know, I don't think anybody enjoyed, like, all of them, but if you did, that's cool. But, you know, if you had your favorites, you can note it in the comments. Oh, one thing I do want to know, like, I guess in the comments, leave your favorite Octane Blue moment. You know, one maybe from, like, one of my solo playthroughs, or one from, like, a multiplayer playthrough. But, like, your favorite moment in one of my videos for this year, or you can name as many as you want, but kind of be specific. I just kind of want to know what people remember or what people are looking forward to. Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm gonna end the video here. But yeah, thanks for listening, and look forward to uploading more in 2012. I have some really cool stuff planned for next year. All right, thanks for watching, and see you next time. Have a happy New Year and stuff like that. Bye.
Oh, what the fuck?
Oh.